For most of us, buying a home will be the biggest purchase we make in our lives, so you want to make sure you get it right. Real estate expert TJ Larsen joins us to talk about what most people are doing wrong. Hopefully everyone can learn from this. TJ, good to see you.
Good to see you as well.
Okay, the first mistake, not hiring an agent.
I've got good news.
Okay.
Most people are doing this right. About 85% of the buyers in our area are using a real estate agent for their transaction. So they're starting off on the right road. First thing that I would say is necessary for hiring a real estate agent, the reason that they should not purchase without one, mm-hmm. is the prices are all over the place. The market's crazy right now. There's things that are priced too low. There's things that are priced too high. There doesn't seem to be a lot of reason as to where pricing is. So need to talk to an experienced real estate agent. We've talked about this before. Find someone experienced. Find somebody who knows the neighborhood. Find somebody who's got solid testimonials. They're going to be able to help you figure out what the current value is and hopefully what the future value is.
Yes, I can't imagine going through that process without an agent. Really, I can't imagine. I don't just say that because you're here. I mean that. I don't think I could do it.
You know, there's so much that's done, and again, we've talked about this. It's free to the buyer.
Yeah.
In most cases, it is paid for by the listing agent. So take advantage of that. It's a free service.
Absolutely. Also, mistake number two, you say, is not getting an inspector.
It is, yeah. This, for most people, is going to be the biggest purchase of their lives. A typical home inspection, we're looking anywhere between $200 and $400 to do a home inspection. Buying a $300,000 property and not being willing to spend $200 to $400, it doesn't make any sense. What's the worst that's going to happen? You're going to find that there's nothing wrong with the house and you wasted $200 to $400. That's a small price to pay for peace of mind.
Absolutely. That makes sense to me, too. Also, then the third mistake, changing your financial status before closing.
Don't change anything. Don't put any more credit card debt on. Don't even pay your credit card off. Keep everything status quo. When your loan officer looks at your, looks at your books, so to speak, and looks at your credit worthiness, they want to approve you at that time, and they want that to stay, your credit approval to stay exactly the same from the time that they tried to approve you to the time that you close. Big mistakes that people make, they'll go out, they'll purchase a car, they'll lease a car. That's going to change your credit worthiness. Keep your job. You know, don't make a change in jobs. If you know that you've got an upcoming change happening, close before you make that change. So keep everything status quo.
Okay. Also, make sure you know the neighborhoods. But if you find a house that you like, spend some time doing some research, perhaps, on knowing more about the neighborhood.
Absolutely. I recommend going out, eating at the local restaurants in that neighborhood, drive by the schools in that neighborhood, places that you would go on an everyday basis. Go to your post office. You know, mm-hmm. Your commute. Drive from your house in the morning at around the time that you would have the commute. Drive back around 5 o'clock at the normal time you would have the commute. Make sure that you're comfortable. This is a long-term purchase. You need to be comfortable in the neighborhood.
That makes sense, too, to feel what it would be like to actually live there. And like you said, try the local restaurants. I like that tip. Also, you see, another mistake is not going back for a second visit. Do people really do that? They don't go back for a second visit?
Not as much anymore.
Okay. I know, right?
But it does stop the impulse. By. And you really want to check this property out at least twice. Now, if you've got a property that has a lot of activity that's going on with it, you may not have time to wait until the next weekend to go to that property. You might want to see it twice in one day. But, you know, check it out after 5 o'clock. If you saw it at noon, go back at 6 o'clock. Mm-hmm. See what cars are in the driveway. Make sure that you're comfortable with it. I promise you, you will pick up on things that you didn't pick up on the first time. It's just like watching a movie. You know, every time you watch the movie, you see something you didn't see before.
That's so true. TJ Larsen, mytownhome.com. Check out his website, mytownhome.com. Always good to see you.
You as well.
All right, thanks, TJ.